I understand from watching television that the country happens to be kind of on fire. Pretty hot throughout the country. I'm going to have very specific numbers for you in a second, but let's watch the news coverage right now.
We begin with the heat wave that's burning up so much of the country.
The National Weather Service calls the heat historic.
It's an epic heat wave.
An intense heat so severe.
We were on pace with the temperatures that were in Saudi Arabia and deserts all over the country with some of the hottest temperatures in the world.
Some of the hottest temperatures in the world. We're on fire. It's epic. You know that there's a phenomenon called global warming? Could that be a part of it? No. Shh. Almost none of the news reports, in fact, literally none of the news reports in this cycle, because we tracked it, have mentioned global warming at all. And if they ever do mention it, they'll have an expert on and they'll say, well, some are theorizing this thing called climate change. And otherwise, and other people obviously think this has absolutely nothing to do with it. So I've done my balance. Now, here's what we do on this program. We bring you facts. Not because one weather event or even a stretch of weather doesn't necessarily mean anything about overall climate change. You can have terrible snowstorms. That doesn't mean that you necessarily have climate change. You could have terrible droughts and fires as we do now, and it doesn't necessarily mean climate change. So let's look at the numbers. First of all, how many daily high temperature records were set in just in the month of June? Well, that'd be only 3,215. Now that seems like a pretty high number. I'm going to put it to you in context in just a second. Well, how about so far this year in terms of acres burned in wildfires? How about 2.1 million acres burned? Now, to put that in context, they did a study between 1970 and 2003. The amount of wildfires, land consumed by wildfires, has gone up 6.5 times. So now that's since 1970, in that case, the latest numbers were from 2003, and since then, it's gotten even worse, obviously, and today, it's even breaking more and more records as we speak. So the wildfires are increasing at a significant pace. The heat is going up at a significant pace. In fact, now some of the top climate scientists are saying, yeah, this is exactly what we warned you about. We're in the middle of climate change. It's not something that's going to happen down the road. It's happening right now. So let me quote one for you. Jonathan Overpeck, he's a professor of geoscience and atmospheric science at the University of Arizona. He says, quote, this is what global warming looks like at the regional or personal level. The extra heat increases the odds of worse heat waves, droughts, storms, and wildfire. This is certainly what I and many other climate scientists have been warning about. The part of that quote that I really like is the very beginning where he says, this is what global warming looks like. And we're seeing it all across the country. Obviously, it's not just this latest stretch. You had all the record-breaking temperatures in Chicago in March. All over the country, and right now it's in Atlanta, Nashville, Raleigh, and the list goes on and on. Now, here's another geoscientist, and that's Princeton University professor Michael Oppenheimer, and he says, quote, what we're seeing really is a window into what global warming really looks like. It looks like heat, it looks like fires, it looks like this kind of environmental disasters. Now, I said, okay, now that's the guys who are predicting this, so of course, they're going to say that we're in the middle of this. Well, they predicted it based on the numbers, and the numbers do back them up. I don't want you to get confused about that. But look, let's take it in context, right? So we have all these records. But it turns out, you know, every year we break a lot of records for cold days and hot days. So, for example, you might break a record in Iowa for a cold day, and you might break a record for heat in Georgia. So that happens all the time. In fact, in the last century, the number of cold records and heat records were even. So you didn't really particularly see a trend in that category, right? Well, in the last decade, okay, so the first decade of this century, that number moved to 2 to 1 more heat records as opposed to cold records. Well, how are we doing right now? Well, so far this year, and we're only about through half the year, obviously, well, it turns out we've actually broken 6,000 cold records. So that's a lot of cold temperature records to break. Jeez, I don't know if we're going to be able to keep up with that on the heat side. I do know. 40,000 hot temperature records throughout the country in half a year alone. So now our ratio is nearly 7 to 1. Is global warming happening? The numbers certainly look like it. Now, look, this is macro stuff. So whenever you see a micro event like this, and it doesn't have to be just over a couple of days, it could even be over a couple of years, and it could swing back, and then things could even out. So that's what everybody always says, especially the guys who do the global warming denying. But we've shown you graph after graph on the show in the past. Temperatures rising, every indication rising, the number of extreme weather events through the roof compared to the past. And now you see these hot temperature records, which then, of course, lead to wildfires, etc. And when you look at it, all of it, in its context and in its entirety, I got news for you. We're in the middle of climate change. It's not something that's going to happen later. It's happening right now. So when you turn on your local news and they show you the fires and they show the record-breaking heat, you're looking at global warming.